Now, I hope you're sitting down because I've got some tea to share. Now, I know science is often seen as serious, logical, proper.
Wait, why does a dog show up when I search for royalty-free images of science? Anyway, moving on.
But as someone who's been in the world of science for almost a decade, trust when I tell you that science and scientists have their fair share of drama to spill. And today's drama involves the question, are we alone in the universe? Look, for centuries, we've been looking up at the stars like, what's the deal? Are we the only ones here? And you know, we've all wondered, are there aliens out there more advanced than us, just chilling in some distant solar system? Well, scientists have been on the search for decades through programs like SETI, hoping to catch a glimpse of alien tech that'll finally prove that we're not alone. And trust me, the search has stirred up some drama in the astro world recently. Okay, so the backstory of this drama goes all the way back to the late 19th century, when Nikola Tesla, you know, the Tesla, was like, hey, I think we can contact aliens with one of my inventions. He had this wild idea to send electricity through the air without wires, and he even thought he actually intercepted a signal from Mars. He was dead set convinced that after picking up this weird, repetitive static signal that vanished when Mars disappeared below the horizon. And it doesn't stop there, because a few years later, radio legends like Guglielmo Marconi and even Lord Kelvin started to wonder if their early radio experiments might be picking up Martian signals too. And the obsession was real. Then, in 1924, things got so intense that the US literally held a National Radio Silence Day, where they shut off all radios for 5 minutes every hour, just in case Mars decided to phone home. I mean, can you imagine the suspense? That's when Frank Drake, who's basically the godfather of modern alien hunting, launched Project Ozma, the first SETI experiment. He had this whole radio telescope listening to the stars, hoping to hear something. Spoiler alert, he didn't hear anything. But his work laid the foundation for everything we are doing today. And then, in 1977, things got spicy with the wow signal. This powerful, unexplained signal came in, and everyone kind of freaked out, thinking we might have finally heard from aliens. But of course, no one could ever really pin down what it actually was. Still, it left people buzzing for years. And if you want to know more about that and what we think caused it these days, check out my video. Now, these days, the search for alien life has gone way beyond just listening for radio signals. We're out here looking for biosignatures or technosignatures. Basically, any hint of life from specific chemicals in a distant atmosphere to massive alien megastructures like Dyson spheres that could harness the power of entire stars. And one study is suggesting that we might have found some signs of these Dyson spheres. But that's where the drama begins, because not everyone is buying it. The tea is piping hot in the science world right now. But before we dive into the drama, let's talk about what a Dyson sphere actually is and what scientists are looking for when they go hunting for one. And trust, after that, we'll get to the juicy part. All right, so what is a Dyson sphere? A Dyson sphere is like a solar panel on steroids, but instead of just covering your roof, it's surrounding an entire star and capturing the energy of the star for use by a super smart alien civilization. And fun fact, this whole idea actually started as science fiction. Back in 1937, Olaf Stapledon wrote about it in his novel Star Maker. But then in 1960, physicist Freeman Dyson, yes, that Dyson, who, by the way, as far as I can tell, is not related to that Dyson. Anyway, he took the idea of these solar panels on steroids and ran with it. He wrote this paper saying if a civilization gets advanced enough, they're gonna need more energy than they can get from their planet alone. So why not go big and harvest the energy from their whole star? At first, Dyson thought of it as like a giant shell around the star, but then he was like, okay, maybe a solid structure won't actually work because it's mechanically impossible. Slight little problem. So he reimagined it instead as a Dyson swarm, a whole bunch of objects orbiting the star independently, scooping up all the energy. And Dyson said that if aliens were out there building these massive structures, they'd be giving off loads of infrared radiation. So if we want to find one of these Dyson spheres, all we need to do is look for stars that are leaking extra heat in the form of infrared light, like way more than what a normal star would give off. And that's what teams of scientists like Sayuzo and friends search for when looking for Dyson spheres, stars with uncharacteristic extra infrared radiation. And here's where the drama begins. Okay, so let's talk about the first paper by Sozo and friends and jump straight to the results. They claim that they have found 7 stars within 1,000 light years of us that might have partial Dyson spheres around them. But here's where the tea gets piping hot. The title of the paper totally claims that they found Dyson sphere candidates. The abstract, same thing, totally confident. But if you scroll to the very last line of the conclusions, they do a complete backflip. Like, hold up, you spent the whole paper hyping up these Dyson sphere candidates, and now you're telling us it's premature to even think that. This screams peer review intervention to me. Someone probably said, hold up, turn it down. And that caution didn't quite make it to the title and abstract of the paper. And it gets juicier because not even a month later, just 20 days to be exact, another group, Ren and Friends, came in hot with a rebuttal. 20 days later. And this all went down in the research notes of the AAS, which, by the way, aren't peer-reviewed, but they're still a place where people drop comments, clarifications, and in this case, a bit of a professional, well, actually. So what's their argument? Ren and Friends are saying that 3 of Sozo's Dyson sphere candidates could actually be things called hot dogs.
Let's start with a hot dog.
Yeah, you can't make this stuff up. These are hot, dust-obscured galaxies. These galaxies are covered in dust, and they show up in exactly the same infrared bands that Dyson spheres would be expected to show up in. So Ren and Friends also did some cross-checking with radio surveys and found that 3 out of the 7 Dyson sphere candidates from Sozo and Friends' paper lined up with known hot dogs. I can't take myself seriously when I say that. But they were like, well, if 3 of them are galaxies and maybe the other 4 are too, we just need better data to prove it. So basically, they're suggesting that probably not aliens, guys, just dusty galaxies messing with your data. And honestly, that does sound like a more straightforward explanation. And look, I get it. The simpler explanation is probably right, but still a bit of a letdown, you know? Because what if these really were Dyson spheres? Like, how cool would that be? It's the kind of extraordinary discovery scientists dream about. But the drama? That's just science doing its thing. Someone makes a bold claim, someone else comes in to call it out, and we, both of those things, we find ourselves getting closer to the best explanation we can find. But as of right now, we've still got no confirmed or even definitely not premature Dyson sphere candidates to get excited about. And who knows where the research will take us next. I mean, it would be super cool to find one, a Dyson sphere, but honestly, when it comes to the search for extraterrestrial life, I'm betting we're more likely to find biosignatures with telescopes like JWST than stumble across technosignatures like a Dyson sphere. What do you think? Let me know in the comments, and don't forget to like this video if you enjoyed it and subscribe for more cosmic content from your friendly astrophysicist, Dr. Kirsten Banks. Stay curious and keep looking up.